bit slower tonight since we've got our new helper here. So if I appear slow, it's because I'm older, but also because we're trying to help facilitate this transition. All right. So is a proper motion? Is there any discussion? All in favor, say aye.
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 Opposed? Ayes have it unanimously. All right. Next will be folks in the audience, items that are not on tonight's agenda. If you'd like to speak to the commission, please come forward. If not, we'll move on. Then we will move to the next item, which is announcements, staff.
Well, since it's December and the end of the year here, I'd just like to wish you all a very happy holiday season and thank all of our planning commissioners for their service this year. We really appreciate all the hard work you put in. And I'd also like to welcome Elaine Ellis, right there next to Chairman Mike Hathaway. She is our new administrative assistant in the planning department. We're very happy to have her, and she'll be creating and helping the commission with all the minutes. So if you ever have any reason to reach out with any minutes needs or anything else, she'll be happy to help. We're very happy to have her.
Yes, welcome. We'll miss Brenda, but we welcome Elaine. Make sure I get my names right. Okay, we will then move on to our position where if you have non-agenda items you'd like to for the commission to consider, please come forward and we'll consider those. All right, I see none, then we'll move to the consent agenda. We have our initial consent, which is items 2 through 6, items 11 and 15. That is on our initial consent agenda. We'll have a secondary consent after that. These are items that are considered non-controversial. They will vote on at one time. Is anyone in the audience, staff, or commission that want to pull items from that initial consent? All right, seeing none, then do I have a motion?
Move for approval.
Second.
Moved by Scott and seconded by Alma. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed? Ayes have it. Then I will pass the baton over to Roger to deal with item number 12.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Item number 12 will be heard on secondary consent. Item 12 is McEwen Place PUD subdivision final plat for section 3 revision 2. So secondary consent for item 12. And we've got a couple of commissioners that need to recuse. Okay. So is there a motion to approve?
Move for approval.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed? Motion carries unanimously.
Thank you, Roger.
Mr. Chairman.
All right, then we'll move on to item number 7, ordinance 2016-48. Ordinance to be rezoned 1.30 acres from detached residential R2 to general office GO, located west of Royal Oaks Boulevard and north of Murfreesboro Road. Staff?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The existing land use plan and Envision Franklin supports this rezoning request. This property is one of the four lots mentioned in the existing land use plan that would be appropriate for an office use. Staff recommends favorable recommendation to the Board of Mayor and Aldermen.
All right. Is there anyone in the audience who wants to speak to this item? Seeing none, is there someone representing the applicant? If you'll come forward.
Good evening. My name is Adam Kronk with Kronk Engineering, here to answer any questions or concerns you may have.
All right. Thank you. Do I have a motion?
Move for approval.
Second.
You're relinquishing your motion to be a second? Okay, Alma. Motion and I'll Scott second. Seconded. All right, any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it unanimously. Item number 8, consideration resolution 2016-45, resolution adopting a plan of services for the annexation of 459, 463, and 467 Franklin Road. Staff?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Resolution 2016-45 is a City of Franklin drafted plan of service for the properties being considered for annexation, located at 459, 463, and 467 Franklin Road. The plan of services outlines how infrastructure will be extended to serve the proposed annex properties and how the city will provide for the safety of residents of the newly annexed properties. This plan of service includes 3 single-family dwelling units, and staff recommends favorable recommendation to the Board of Mayor and Aldermen.
All right. Anyone in the audience wants to speak to this item? If you would come forward. Go ahead.
Yes, sir.
Come forward and to the podium so we can hear you. If you could.
Can I just speak loudly? Since.
Well, I think the television cameras, I don't think can hear you from there. That's the only reason that.
Okay.
Apologize that unless we can move the podium.
Excuse me for a second.
Sure.
Mr. Chair, I think we're trying to find a microphone that we may move closer.
Okay.
So.
No, you're fine.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Appreciate your comments. Great, thank you. We'll need to get a future microphone that can be removed if we
yes.
have that again. I apologize.
It's all right. Thank you for the opportunity. I just am curious about the realization of only annexing 3 parcels with this proposal. Or would it be the entire length of Franklin Road from, we don't have a full picture of the map, but where the top county line is to the bottom county line, I think it ends at Mac Hatcher. Would it be just those 3 parcels that would be approved, just that?
That is correct.
Wow.
It is just these 3 parcels that have come in for annexation.
Okay.
I think you have to ask now to be annexed.
Yes.
In other words, we don't. The city doesn't pick something to be annexed. I think the landowners have to request being annexed.
Okay. Because my question really is, would the city of Franklin install sewage lines all the way down Franklin Road, but only allow connection to those 3 properties in a residential? Coding change for those 3 parcels.
Jimmy Wiseman from the engineering department.
All right, thank you.
I'm Jimmy Wiseman, assistant city engineer. The sewer is already installed on Franklin Road, so really these 3 parcels are only required to bore underneath Franklin Road to tie onto existing sewer. So a lot of the infrastructure is already in place.
Right, wonderful. Okay, because my concern was I didn't know it existed, and I felt that I would be required to connect to it 1,000 feet off of the road, so it would be a very expensive matter for myself. And, just didn't think the city would annex just 3 little parcels out of more than 2 dozen. Thank you. Thank you.
Great, thank you.
Sir, can we get your name for the record, please?
Sure, my name is Daniel Hollingsworth.
Okay, thank you, Daniel. All right. Anyone else? All right, seeing none, then is there someone representing the applicant for this one?
Good evening. Adam Kronk with Kronk Engineering here to answer any questions or concerns you may have.
All right, is there a motion?
Move for approval.
Second.
Okay, motion by Scott, seconded by Roger. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Item number 9, resolution 2016-85, ordinance 2016-49 to be entitled a resolution and ordinance to annex 459, 463, and 467 Franklin Road. Staff?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Resolution 2016-85 and ordinance 2016-49 is a document required to annex the 5.4 acres of property into the Franklin city limits. The property is adjacent to the current city limits and within the city's established urban growth boundary. A plan of service and zoning ordinance will accompany this resolution/ordinance. Staff recommends favorable recommendation to the Board of Mayor and Aldermen.
All right, thank you. Is anyone in the audience would like to speak to this item? All right, is there someone representing the applicant?
Yes, Adam Kronk here to answer any questions you may have.
You've done a good job of making that sound exactly the same every single time.
Thanks.
All right. Is there a motion?
Move for approval.
Second.
Okay, Scott motioned and Marcia seconded. All right, any other discussion? All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed? Ayes have it unanimously. Item number 10, consideration ordinance 2016-50 to be entitled ordinance to zone 5.4 acres detached residential R1 district, Hillside, Hillcrest overlay, HHO district, Berry's Chapel character overlay, area overlay district, and designate the development standards as being appropriate for either traditional or conventional development standards. Yeah. Staff.
Yeah, this is the last one. The existing land use plan and Envision Franklin support the zoning request to remain detached residential for these properties. The base zoning of detached residential 1 is consistent with the zoning along this stretch of Franklin Road. Staff recommends favorable recommendation to the Board of Mayor and Aldermen.
All right, anyone in the audience want to speak to this item? Okay, seeing none, is there an Adam in the audience anywhere?
Right here. Adam Kronk here to answer any questions you may have.
All right, thank you. Is there a motion?
Second.
Okay, moved by Alma, seconded by Scott. Any other discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? The ayes have it. All right, I will pass the chair over to Mr. Lindsay for the next two items.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Item number 13, McEwen Place PUD subdivision, site plan section 3, lot 302, block B, 207,600 square feet of commercial space and 76 attached residential units on 4.99 acres with one design modification for building length. Staff?
Thank you, Mr. Vice Chair. The site plan for this part of the McEwen PUD subdivision includes an office building, a one-story retail building, and a parking garage wrapped with attached residential units. The development plan revision for this section was approved by the Planning Commission at the special FMPC meeting held November 7th, 2016. The applicant requests a design modification from section 5.3.5B2 to allow for an attached residential building to be longer than 200 feet. The longest elevation is 400 feet in length. Staff finds that this design modification is appropriate because the applicant has suitable architectural detailing and articulation along the long facades. Staff recommends approval of this design modification and approval with conditions for this site plan.
Okay, thank you. Is there anyone in the audience that would like to speak to this item? Seeing no one, is there someone representing the applicant?
Good evening. I'm Ryan McMaster with Kimley Horn. I'd be happy to address any questions you have today.
Thank you, Ryan. We'll handle this as a main motion for the item, and follow prior to approval. We'll follow with a motion for the modification of standard. So, is there a motion for this item?
Move for approval with staff conditions.
Second.
We have a motion and a second, and then there is the item for the design modification for building length. Is there a motion to allow the design modification on the project?
So,
this is on the apartment building,
no,
right?
No, we have to do the modification.
We're going to vote on the modification, and
this is on the Spring Creek Drive multifamily, correct? Is that the section?
Multifamily. Modification. This is Rush Street. And
the modification of standards covers the attached residential building that's along Rush Street and Spring Rush, Creek, yeah. Drive.
Okay, right. So I'm looking at the right one. Thank you.
It's going to be 400 feet. Various elevations.
The longest elevation is 400 feet in length.
But the design moves, I mean, changes along there.
That's correct.
Different. Okay.
Move for approval.
Yeah, we've got a motion by Scott, and Alma has seconded. Is there any discussion on the modification of standard? Seeing none, all in favor of the motion?
Aye.
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 Any opposed? Motion carries unanimously. Okay, we'll go back to the main motion then. We have a motion and a second. With that approved, modification of standard. All in favor? Is there any further discussion at this point? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries unanimously. Item number 14, McEwen Place PUD subdivision site plan section 3, lots 303 and 304. This is block C. 274 attached residential units on 4.41 acres and one open space lot on 2.82 acres with one design modification, again on building length, located near the intersection of Rush Street and East McEwen Drive. Staff?
Thank you, Mr. Vice Chair. The site plan for this part of McEwen PUD subdivision includes one attached residential building with 274 dwelling units. The development plan revision for this section was approved by Planning Commission at the special FMPC meeting held November 7, 2016. The applicant requests a design modification from section 5.3.5B2 to allow for an attached residential building to be longer than 200 feet. The longest elevation is 465 feet in length. Staff finds that this design modification is appropriate because the applicant has suitable architectural detailing and articulation along their long facades. Staff recommends approval of this design modification, and staff also recommends approval with conditions of this site plan.
Thank you, Josh. Okay, is there anyone in the audience who'd like to speak to this item? Seeing none, is there anyone representing the applicant? Ryan?
I'm Ryan McMaster with Kimley Horn. I'd be happy to address any questions.
Okay. Do you have a motion, a main motion for this item?
Move for approval.
We have a motion by Marcia.
Second.
And a second by Jimmy. We'll go then to the motion for the approval of the design modification for the building length. Is there a motion for that design modification?
I move for approval.
Second. We have a motion by Ann and a second by Alma. Is there any discussion on the design modification? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries unanimously. Back to the main motion for the site plan. We have a motion and a second. Is there any further discussion?
Yes, could I amend the motion to be approval with staff conditions?
Certainly. Motion.
I amend my original motion to include staff conditions. That's what I was looking for on here. Couldn't find it.
Okay. Is there any other discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries unanimously.
Mr. Chair, now you actually have a main motion in front of you with the design modification and the amendment for staff conditions. So.
One more vote.
Okay, so
we voted on the amendment.
Yes. So you have a main motion with two amendments right now in front of you.
Correct.
Ready for a vote.
Okay. The motion to modify the original. Okay.
Right.
Does everybody understand what that motion is?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries unanimously. Thank you, Council.
You're welcome.
Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Roger. All right, item number 16, consideration of ordinance 2016-45, and an ordinance to be entitled amending chapter 3 of the zoning ordinance in order to add parking structures to the list of permitted new uses, encroachments in the FFO floodway fringe. Staff?
Thank you, Mr. Chair. This item has been discussed at several joint conceptual workshop meetings, including the one earlier this evening, so I'm not going to go into too much detail. You've got all that information in your staff report. But the proposed amendment removes the requirement that parking lots be completely constructed of pervious pavers, asphalt, or concrete, and adds parking structures to the list of permitted uses and encroachments that may be constructed and encroached within the 100-year floodplain FFO boundary. The parking lot change is to bring that section of the ordinance into compliance with the stormwater management ordinance. As far as the addition of parking structures as a permitted encroachment, there are two options presented in the ordinance that a parking structure could be constructed with. If it's constructed with perimeter foundation walls, those have to be constructed in accordance with the floodplain regulations. If it's built on support piers, it must provide adequate clearance for the maintenance underneath those areas. If there is parking that is provided on the ground level, then that clearance amount will be based on the building code. If there's no parking underneath the parking structure that's on a support pier, the requirement is 7 feet. However, an applicant would have an opportunity to request an alternative height from the design, from the development review team, that would let a lower height be approved if it was appropriate based on the review of that body. Any ground level parking that would be provided would be required to be screened as according to the zoning ordinance. And no below grade or basement level parking would be permitted. And as far as any uses, no other uses would be permitted to be constructed above a parking structure located within the 100-year floodplain or FFO. If a use was to be constructed above a parking structure outside of that area, that would be permitted. It just, the entire building would have to meet the floodplain standards. This proposed amendment is in keeping with the policies that are outlined in the Franklin Land Use Plan that promote the conservation of our conservation areas and floodplains. The proposed amendment establishes strict standards for the development of parking structures and parking lots to minimize the amount of development permitted to encroach into the floodplain and have a minimal impact on those conservation areas. And for that reason, we're recommending approval of this ordinance. And so staff's recommendation is that you recommend approval of ordinance 2016-45 to the Board of Mayor and Aldermen.
All right, thank you, Jim. Even though there's only staff left, I'll still ask, is there anyone in the audience, anybody at home that wants to call in? anybody that wants to comment? I see none, then the applicant is the city, so I'll assume that we're good. So is there a motion?
Mr. Chairman, I recommend approval to the Board of Mayor and Aldermen of Ordinance 2016-45.
Okay. Okay, properly motioned with Roger, seconded by Mike. Michael, is it Mike or Michael, does it matter?
They both work.
Mr. Orr. All right, so we have a proper motion. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? The ayes have it unanimously. And before we leave, I'll echo what Emily said. Thank each of you for your efforts this year. I can't believe it's been another year, but it has. Wow, busy year, and a lot of things change in Franklin. And staff, thank you guys. You chose a profession that requires you to be with us at least once a month in the evening, having dinner with us and everything. So thank you for those who are away from your families and do what you do. We appreciate your efforts. Always helpful for us, for sure. So with that, I wish everybody a Merry Christmas, yes. And I will ask for a motion for adjournment.
So moved.
Second.
Okay. All in favor of adjournment, say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? We are adjourned. Have a great rest of the year.
25
See you
minutes.
Next year.